Every day, millions of kids play street ball and dream of someday playing in the NBA. Most reach a point when they know it's an impossible dream, but dreams die hard. Each year, thousands of college stars compete for a handful of NBA contracts and a few hundred international ones. Most don't make it. Skill, determination, and incredible hard work aren't enough. You need two more things. You need a little bit of luck, and you need a good agent. Eric Fleisher is a sports agent. He sells dreams.
He's about 3 or 4. He always wanted balls to play around with. Like I said, all the games, they were always mad at Bo, you know. Stop that boy, stop that boy.
Eric met Bo when he was scouting another player in New Orleans. He had extraordinary ball control. He was also fearless, a football player's body and toughness playing point guard. He also had that look in his eyes, the intensity, the fire, the look Marbury and Garnett had. All the great ones have it. Bo was also life-hardened. He had already endured so much. His little brother was killed when Bo was only 14, and then Katrina hit. How could he be afraid of his own trap when he watched as his home and his entire neighborhood, his world, were wiped out? But he kept struggling back, and just when things seemed hopeful, and he would sign a scholarship to play ball with Oklahoma State, disaster struck again.
Now, we were excited, of course, and Bo was too, so we had a big party set up and everything on signing day, and the scholarship never came. And we had, you know, had a press conference set up and had all the family and friends there. You know, Bo was just so heartbroken, and so was I. Bo cried many nights. You know, I was also upset because I didn't know where he was going to go. And I just told him not to worry. We're going to find your school.
Bo ended up playing for the University of New Orleans. Eric signed him, and he was able to get him several workouts with NBA teams. But they didn't give him much of a chance. So Eric got him a deal for a couple of $100,000 to play with Partizan in Belgrade, Serbia, one of the most exciting places in the world to play basketball. When he was first told about Partizan, Bo thought it was a suburb in Paris. No one can possibly be prepared for what it's like to play in front of 20,000 of the most emotionally charged fans in the world. Eric's only advice for Bo was not to miss too many easy layups. You don't know how they might react. But Partizan loved Bo, and Bo loved Partizan. And he carried the team to its first ever Final Four appearance. It was an incredibly emotional series, with the final game going right down to Bo's last shot at the buzzer.
Finish it. Bo, hey, how are you? Let me tell you something. You played your tail off. I'm proud of you. I know your mom is too. You did great. I thought you had the last shot. It looked good. My friend, you put yourself on the map. You really helped yourself. Nah, listen, over the last couple of days, I've already spoken to several teams. It's going to be an interesting summer.
Every day is exciting because you never know what the next call is going to lead to. Will it be the next Steve Nash or Nash Bridges? The Kobes, the LeBrons, and the Garnets don't sneak up on anybody. But with 30 NBA teams and over 1,000 around the world, there are interesting possibilities every single day. The goal for Bo was to get big money in one of the strongest and most successful teams in Europe, Siena, in Tuscany, Italy, a beautiful part of the world. Bo would have loved to return to Partizan. They just didn't have the money, but Eric had to give them first option.
Absolutely. Bo would love to return, you know that. Now, how do we make it work? I need you to stretch. I need you to dig down deep and go to your sponsors. You gotta move March, okay? You've gotta create some flexibility here. I will buy as much time as I can, but Sasha, you know, I'm not going to jeopardize and risk Bo getting a deal that provides security for the rest of his life. It's too important. Okay, so you need to move on this thing. And I know you're used to moving slow and precisely, but this is not the time. Okay, he's a proven product. You know him. You know what his value is. Now let's get it done.
Montepeschi Siena is one of the richest clubs in Europe. They're owned by a bank. But they've never spent a lot of money on players. Maybe between the bank and the sponsors, Eric could get them to open up the vault.
Ciao, Fernando. I'm good. How about you? Let's not waste time. Tell me what you can do. Fernando, come on. Okay. First of all, your club is owned by a bank. Open up the bank. Get this thing done. Don't be silly. Why would you take a chance of, you know, not signing a player that is the best young guard in all of Europe? Look, Fernando, you're talking about, you know, offering the kid $500,000 to $600,000 maybe, okay, per year. For that kind of money, tomorrow I can re-sign him in Partizan. You're gonna have to do a lot better. Find a way for the club to stretch. Get up into an excess of $1 million a year, okay? And that's a low number. Bottom line is that you're getting the best young point guard in Europe, and you're getting him in his prime. And after 2 years, in his second year, he carried his team to the Final Four, which is unprecedented. Tomorrow's fine, but don't sleep on this thing, Fernando.
Eric didn't have to wait till tomorrow. He got the call from Fernando that night while he was at an exhibition game in Hartford. When he hung up the phone, he was able to look forward to asking Bo his favorite question.
You sitting down? Sienna came through.
Whoa.
Yep. It's an unbelievable deal for you, my friend. Not only, okay, are they going to pay you what works out to, in NBA dollars, over $2 million a year, but they're going to give you 3 years of protection.
Sweet.
And you're going to have the right to get out every year so that you can go sign in the NBA or you can go sign someplace else. And if that happens, you make even more money because you share in the buyout. Bo, I am happy for you. I really am. You earned it. You worked your tail off.
That's great. Tell me about that money part again.
It works out to about, well, just over $2 million a year in NBA money. It's a lot of money, Bo.
You know what, Eric? I gotta say something. You've always been there for me, and I really appreciate it.
I'm happy for you, I really am.
Every week you get 15 to 20 highlight reels from a kid looking to get a job, any job, just to get paid to play the game he loves. You work out a few. Sometimes there might even be a good fit somewhere. The hardest part of the job is when you have to tell a kid he's just not good enough. Or after he's just worked out for a team where he thought he had a good chance of getting a contract, the GM says the kid can't even play dead. But the toughest calls to make are the ones when you have to tell a kid who's been playing for 3 weeks in a city he loves, and he's sending his paycheck back home to help out his mom and family, that he's been cut, and he needs to pack up tonight and get on a plane home tomorrow morning. Those are the toughest calls to make. The best part of the job is sitting down with a kid who has just become a millionaire and watching his face as it settles in as he realizes after all the hard work and after suffering so much hardship for so long, he now knows he and his family will be comfortable for the rest of their lives. And there are those special times when you go to meet a kid at his parents' apartment when he's going to sign his $18 million contract. And as he is signing his name, they all have tears streaming down their faces. Those moments don't happen often enough, but they are unforgettable.
I just love my baby, you know. I'm just so proud. I'm just so proud of him.
Bo was the leading scorer in Siena, and the team is starting off the season with its best record ever, 5-0. Bo's mom has a new computer, and she and little Bo watch his games live on the internet. They're happy. Eric was able to get Bryce a position on a team in Iceland. While he's only making $1,500 a month, and he's sleeping on a bunk bed, it's beautiful there, and he's still chasing his dream. And Mark, after playing for 2 years in Germany, has decided to move on. With a degree in finance from Brown University, he's taken a job with an investment firm in New York City. Bo is on his way to Madrid to play the defending champions, so today was a good day. And you know there's another Bo out there somewhere. Maybe Eric will find him tomorrow.